Hey guys, what's up? It's Alex here. Today you're here with the Winter Championship 2015/2016. Here are the teams for the annual endurance race, I suppose. Yeah, so here we are. So here's team one, is my dad by himself. Team two is Tomel and Oliver. Team three is Will and John. So John and Oliver, both newcomers. And then team four is myself and James. And this is qualifying for anyone wondering. So in front we've got Tomel. To the right we had my dad. We also have Will there as well, and I'll let you guys know what everyone else's sort of, you know, looks like when they go karting when we switch over halfway through the qualifying session. So basically it is a 10 minute qualifying session, 20 minute race. So as I said, we have two new people go karting today. We have Oliver, who is a friend of Tom L, and then also we've got John, who's a friend of me and Will. So yeah, weird story with John, obviously. You guys might not know, but I've actually known him since primary school, and through secondary school. We were in different years at school, so we didn't really speak much. And then I went to work at a sort of a Saturday job, and then he was working there, so it was kind of weird that how we were like good friends in primary school, and then like 7 years later we didn't spoke for ages, and then we suddenly sort of start speaking again at this Saturday job. So yeah, he's go-karting here today for the first time. He said he's done a little bit of I think it was like not catch or something, you know, like little go-karting around where we live. So yeah, he's done a little bit before, and I'm not sure about Oliver what his experience was in go-karting, but it should be pretty interesting. I think the teams are pretty even. Obviously my dad, he doesn't need to switch over because there's only him in his team, if that makes any sense. So he can just drive through the pit lane, so he doesn't need to do any of any of that changing stuff, which actually does cost you probably about 10 seconds there. So he could be making up like a lap basically by not having to stop, if that makes any sense. As long as he has a clear run through the pit lane, he could gain about 10 seconds, so that could be pretty important from here. And you can see there, Will goes past James, who we're riding on board with. I didn't mention that, James is starting off the qualifying session and the race, but yeah, that's James gone through there, and Tomel's up the road, and my dad's just behind at the moment. So yeah, good start from James, but he has started to fall back a little bit here, and I think my dad is actually quite close to him. You can see Will on really, he needs to be on good form, so does Tomel. Both of them have rookie teammates in this endurance race. And how the endurance race itself is going to work is every 5 minutes in the race, it's a 20 minute race, and then every 5 minutes we're going to switch over. So James will start, then I'll switch over after 5 minutes, then James will hop back in for 5 minutes, and then I'll do the last 5 minutes. That's how it works out. Last year we did a 40 minute endurance, if I remember correctly, but I forgot to book the time correctly, so I booked us for like 30 minutes, not like the 40 or 50 minutes that we might need for an endurance race, like a proper endurance race. But this is still good, it's still decent enough to have a pretty interesting endurance race once again. It's going to end up like sort of a yearly thing by the look of it. Obviously we did one last year, went down really well. I finished second place with my dad that time. Will and his cousin finished first that time, and this time hoping to get a bit of revenge. Obviously me and James, probably, like, I've got to be honest, probably the strongest driver lineup out of all of us. Unless my dad has a really good race, then I think he's got a really good chance of actually going for the win, actually. My dad, obviously, because he doesn't need to stop, so that will be an advantage for him. We talked about it on the car journey to the track, that we wanted to make it fair for him, obviously, because it's going to be like a long race for him, like 20 minutes non-stop. It's not exactly easy, but it should be interesting. I'm not sure the last time we drove 20 minutes in the go-kart non-stop, so we'll see how he fares. Obviously, it will be quite tiring. Obviously, when we're swapping out every 5 minutes for everyone else, it's quite easy. I mean, 5 minutes, you can just go flat out. You don't need to really worry about getting tired. I mean, I know people, it might sound stupid for me saying that, but you do get tired go-karting, especially your arms, obviously, because sometimes it's weird. Sometimes the go-kart thing's really light and it's all right. Other times, it's like really weird and it's, yes, yeah, not exactly great, but yeah. So you can see here, James is quite way far back from James. quite way back from Tom L and Will at this point here. So I'm expecting, for qualifying, to be perfectly honest, for us to be probably third place on the grid. We'll see how it all plays out, but I'm expecting probably third place on the grid here. But we have got to switch over, and I think it's going to be a switch over any minute now. Sorry, it's going to be a switch over any minute now because it's coming up to the 5 minute mark. Obviously, we're at the 5 minute mark in the video, but we had a bit of me rambling on about the start. So we've probably got two more laps, I'm assuming. The end of this lap here and the lap after will probably be the laps for James in qualifying. Hopefully he's done enough for us here. You'll see, is the board gone out here? We can see we're waiting down there, and I think that was the board just there. So at the end of this lap, James will be coming into the pits. I'll be switching over. I'll be doing 5 minutes or around about 5 minutes of qualifying. I think it actually ended up being about 4 minutes of qualifying. Actually, I didn't get as much time as James, but it doesn't matter too much. As long as we both have a bit of experience in the car on the track before the race, I'm confident we have a decent chance of battling for the win. So you can see coming around the final proper corner here, the sunlight's crazy on this camera. I don't know why, guys. I'm really sorry about that. There's nothing obviously I can do about it, but the camera sort of shine is the sun's crazy. But here we are into the pit lane here. James, you can see in his yellow and black Jordan overalls. For anyone wondering, Jordan F1 team looked a bit like that, the overalls. And you can see that is John just in front here. So I'm waiting up behind here. So John's like, what's happening? I'm like, go on, John, go. So yeah, so John's just in front here. He switched over from wheel. My dad would have just kept going round. So he's got quite a big advantage now. So yeah, we've switched over. So who's on the track at the moment, you're probably wondering. So my dad, obviously, myself, John, who's just in front of us here. And we've got Oliver, who's Tom L's friend, who's also out on the track there as well. So yeah, I'll point out Oliver when we do see him on the track. So you can see here, I'm just looking around. My dad's got quite a big advantage. He's nearly lapped me. So you can see he's going to have a big advantage. We did actually discuss maybe him not stopping at all, him just keep going around the track, but yeah, it wasn't going to be very fair if he just kept going around. He'd have been at least two or three laps ahead, basically, if we had agreed that he just kept going around because he was so far ahead. So, yeah, obviously in qualifying, there's no point in him driving through the pit lane. It's just a waste of time. And this is John here. He didn't have exactly the best start for him there. He got onto the track and had a little mistake. But it's all about learning. It's the first time you go go-kart here. It's all about learning, getting used to the track, and just sort of understanding how the carts work and everything. So for John, it doesn't really matter what his lap time is here today. He just needs to learn the track and understand how the racing is and everything. So you can see here, we're going to try and get past him as quickly as possible here. We're looking to the outside. No, switching back to the inside. We're going to get past. No, John, he's breaking right in that corner. You don't need to break there, lad. Anyway, up across the sort of start line. Not the finish line. Up across the start line. Up to the first corner here. This is my first proper lap of first proper lap really in this go-kart, so I've got to try and see what I can do here. The tyres, obviously, maybe want to be bringing up to a bit of temperature, but let's be honest, James has been out there for a bit of time. But made a mistake here. That's the mistake I was making a lot in qualifying, that corner there. I didn't understand for the first couple of times when I went through there what happened. You can see I was shaking my head there. I was like, what happened through that corner there? And eventually, a couple of laps in, I realised, oh, it's rainy. Well, it's not rainy, obviously, it's damp on that part of the track there, so that's why I was sliding out every time I went through that corner. So I needed to, I think it happened every lap in qualifying, to be perfectly honest, because I didn't really know how to adjust to it. So I just kept going flat out through it here. You can see once again, I was like, is there something wrong with the car? That's what I normally do when I look around like that, sort of look around to the back of the car, like, is there something wrong with this car there? But a few laps in, I did eventually realize that part of the track was damp. And obviously, when you're trying to go through there full speed on a damp part of the track, it's not exactly the best thing in the world, as I inevitably will slide out. So, top corner once again, a quick left, then the quick right. I really love this track, it's just so much fun. If you live in sort of the Sussex area, it's definitely worth checking out. Filching Manor is where it is. And you can see there, we went around that corner, finally, without sliding wide, so that's good. So, heading up to the start-finish line now, we probably only have about two laps remaining, to be perfectly honest here. And yeah, I'm really not sure how the qualifying went for me, to be perfectly honest. Obviously, I felt I was making mistakes, so I could tell that maybe I wasn't going to be on the first position on the grid. But it's really to see whether I was fast enough to beat Tom L, because I just sort of assumed Will, seeing how quick he was in qualifying, I was just assuming he's going to be on pole position. But the target for me was to try and beat Tom Elle, who was probably sitting in second position. James didn't have exactly the greatest qualifying session. James, I mean, he probably admits it himself, he's never good in qualifying, but always comes good in the race. He's always really good at being consistent throughout the race, and he's always slow in the first race and then really fast in the second race. I don't know how it works out for him, but that's how the sort of the trend for him is he normally is much faster in the second race. And I think this is Oliver we're seeing on the screen right now. It took me a lot of qualifying to catch up to him, and there's the checkered flag, and let's see what the results were at the end of the day. We did actually manage to get second place, which is interesting. We managed to beat Tom Elle. I'm not sure whose effort that was, James or mine, that got that second place, but obviously John and Will on pole position. My dad, weirdly, down in P4. I thought he was doing pretty good. But anyway, race time. You can see James is who we're starting with. I decided he thought he might be best off starting. You can see there's Will on pole position. Come on, James, you can do it. You get a good start. What we needed from here, from James, as I was saying to John whilst we were standing watching the start here, was like, James, he needs to get a good start. He needs to somehow defend from Tom Elle, who inevitably get a good start. And then he needs to make sure that he gets ahead of Will, get to that inside, and defend the position. Then we have a really good chance of holding up Will a little bit, holding up Tom Elle for a little bit. And then hopefully, by the time my stint comes in, hopefully I'll have enough. But definitely someone to look out for in this race is my dad here, guys. Definitely someone to look out for as the lights go green. James gets a good start. Is it good enough to go up into first position? I think he's really close here with Will on the inside, but I think he's done enough, has he? He's left the door open slightly, but James, with a great start, goes from second place on the grid up to the lead. So here we are in the lead of this race here. Now, that's exactly what I wanted. I said to John, as I was speaking on the sidelines here, I was like, that's exactly what I wanted from James there, to get that leading position. And then it was really, you know, Will was inevitably going to be able to get past at some point, but I was like, let's see how long James can defend from him. And James was very fast there today, but Will was just on another level. But it's actually Tom Elle who gets through first, with Will managing to make the move at the same time here. All very close there. Will nearly hits the side of Tom Elle. It's all very close here, and I was hoping at this point James would sort of follow their lines, but they must have pretty decent carts here today, guys. I mean, sorry about the sun, obviously. I can't do anything about that. But yeah, the sun's sort of ruining parts of the track here where you can't really see much. But yeah, look at this. James just, I don't know what's wrong with this car. It wasn't exactly the greatest car, I'm not going to lie. It wasn't exactly the greatest car. But at this point, I was like, right, let's just see. Hopefully James will put in some consistent lap times here. And, Tom Elle is definitely defending from Will here, so we've got a chance of just keeping up with him here at this point. So James doing a good job. You know, we sort of just said, just keep it on the track, and we've got a good chance here today. You know, no mistakes, and that'll be good. So yeah, you can see Will is definitely pressuring Tom Elle here. And I think he's gone to the inside. He's made the move. He's moved up into the lead there, Will. So good stuff from Will. He obviously reclaimed that position. Oh, James has gone a bit wider. He's gone on the grass here. I don't know whether my dad is close enough to capitalise on that and go for the overtake. I don't think he is. Oh, he is. He's looking down the inside. He's gone for the move. My dad goes up into third position there. So a really good start for James here. But a slight mistake there on, was this about the third or fourth lap here, going slightly wide. And that moves us down to last position here. And my dad, who's probably the biggest contender to us in this race at the moment at least. I know it sounds weird considering we're battling over third and fourth, but obviously remember the front two guys have rookie teammates, so this could actually be the battle for the win you're looking at right now. As James, side by side with my dad, he's going out to the top corner. Is he going to break a bit later? He has, down the inside. Great move there from James. Awareness of where my dad was. He capitalised on having the extra straight line speed and moves up into third position once again. Can he chase down Tom Elle? It's going to be a tough task because there is such a big advantage now over the rest of the field. But let's hope that James can do it. Let's see whether he can close down the gap here. The gap to Tom Elle is probably up to about 3 or 4 seconds at this point here. So let's see what he can do. Close down the gap hopefully is a possibility. Out to the top corner here. Braking, turning in. Slightly missing the apex there. It was obviously a bit of a weird track here today. Obviously the same track layout as normal, but some parts of the track were damp, others were really wet. Random bits like that bits were quite wet. other bits were bone dry. You can see this is sort of like this part of the track is slightly damper. You can see the part of the track is slightly darker than it normally would be, with obviously the moisture in there as well. So anyway, up across the start line here, and you can see we haven't really closed much in here on Tom Hill here, but it's pretty similar. I'm not gonna lie, Tom Hill isn't as fast maybe as the qualifying did look here, or at least for me watching in qualifying. Tom Hill was just storming away from James, but as I said, James never has been an incredible qualifier. He normally, you know, comes good in the race and normally puts in the performances when I suppose it really matters for the points. Obviously you get points for pole position, but doesn't matter too much, I suppose, if you get more points in the race here today. So as I mentioned, well, did I mention it? I'm not too sure, but I think I can mention it right now, is that I'm actually recording this after the last round, and well, the last round didn't take place, guys, because the one day of the year where it decides to snow is the day I've got booked for the go-karting finale. So this actually will be the championship finale here. So bit weird, I know, round two is the finale, but it's just how it's played out with the weather. And we're not going to redo it because we need to get into the main season at some point. Obviously when you guys are seeing this, it's probably near February, so actually we need to get into the main season soon, and you know, I might not be around later on in the year, so we're gonna have to get the season underway shortly. So yeah, we're not gonna be doing a full 12 round series like we have done the previous 2 years, guys. We're gonna be switching to a 6 round format, a 12 race format instead of 24 races. It'll save everyone a lot of money, and hopefully for everyone it'll make it exciting as well. Obviously the championship should be a lot closer if we're only doing the 6 rounds, so it should make it a lot closer, and maybe someone else will grab the championship top spot. I mean, I know people are like, people have complained in the past that it's not fair that others don't do all the rounds, and I'm the only one that's completed every round of the go-kart championship. But at the end of the day, guys, not everyone can make every round. So yeah, anyway, pit stop time. I'm rambling on about stuff you guys might not care about, but Tom Hill really did a good job there of sort of just staying with James did a good job at staying with Tom Hill there and switching over here. So James trying to help out with the pedals here, and away we go here. I lost a bit of time here, didn't get in there as quickly as possible, didn't get into the go-kart seat as quickly as possible. James is obviously a lot shorter than me, so he normally has like a sort of, it's like a little like a cushion thing around the seat to sort of make it the seat bigger in a way. So if you're shorter, it's not so much you know, not so far to the pedals. So yeah, that's what he normally has in, but I think he just left it out for this whole race here just to make it easy, obviously, so when we switched out it wasn't so bad. But I didn't actually put the pedals to the right position here. It's a sort of a weird mechanism that the pedals are sort of on that makes it easy to switch between, but I didn't quite do it to the right level of the pedals that you know, so it's still quite short pedals, if that makes any sense, or short for my legs. So it was kind of tough. My legs were a bit bent in this part of the race here, but we did fix it for later on. But yes, a big lead at the moment for John, and second place right now, you're seeing in front, is Oliver. So Oliver's looking to just keep his position here and try and keep ahead of me here. He's going to have a straight line speed because, let's be honest, he's very light, so he's going to be very quick in a straight line. So yeah, I'm trying to go around the outside of him here. Is this going to work out? Oh, he tries. I don't know whether that was purpose, you know, on purpose that he was trying to squeeze me out there, but luckily I avoided it. Anyway, top hairpin time. Is he going to make a mistake? He's looking, well, he's not looking exactly for the apex there, so we're all over the back of him here. Can we get past him? We're looking to the outside here. That's not really an overtaking opportunity. Is it one way, then the next? We're looking, and now we're side by side. I think he's seen me at this point here, and he's on the inside. I think he's jabbed the brakes on a bit too much there, and he's spun around. So now we're into second position, and we've got to try and close down that gap to John. You can see him just at the top of the picture there, I think, and my dad at this point is right behind me. Obviously he didn't stop in the pit, so you can see, I don't know whether you can see it at this point here, but my dad was really close to me here, right behind. He was gaining every sort of tenth of a second I was gaining, because I was still getting used to the car. Obviously he knew what he was doing. So yeah, John, he's probably got about a 10 second advantage. Well, it definitely was about 10 seconds when we left the pit lane. So let's just see now how much of that advantage has stayed here. So I think, you know, we're definitely closing John in a bit here. You can see he's not that far in front of us anymore. But let's be honest, if we make a slight mistake here, my dad's through and he's got a good opportunity to win this race if he just doesn't make any mistakes here. But John, obviously, first time go-kart, and he's had 5 minutes of qualifying to get used to the kart, but obviously you can't learn the whole track in the go-kart in 5 minutes. So yeah, he's going to be slow. We're looking to the outside of John here, who's currently in the lead this race. So this is for the overtake, for the win. And we can look one way to go past him here. Slightly steering in a bit more here, and I looked at John, I just sort of start laughing. I was like, hello, John. Anyway, straight line speed here. It's going to be very even between me and John on the brakes. I'm going to hopefully be a bit later down the inside, up into the first position that we've been wanting. And back where we were on the start of this race, obviously, here with James's great start. So now, can I defend from my dad? Have I got enough speed to keep my dad out of the picture? And oh, Oliver's had a bit of a mistake there. He spun around a bit there. I think he's got it right going once again. But yeah, so interesting stuff here. We're into the lead of the race. We came into the pit lane in third position, and now we're up into first position. So up to the top hairpin here on the brakes at this point. I'm kind of wary that the fact that my dad's quite close here. He's going to be obviously looking for an overtake if I make a mistake. So yeah, definitely I'm not just sort of backing off here because I've got the lead this race here. There's definitely you know what I mean, you know, there's definitely a threat from my dad behind here to him, for him to go for the overtake here. But yeah, he's not too far behind here. I'm not sure if the marshal just showing the inboard. I'm not too sure here. I don't think it was. Maybe it was, I'm not too sure. We'll see at the end of this lap whether we're coming to the pit. I don't think it is. I think we've got one more lap after this though, so got a nice little gap, I think, to my dad. It's probably going to be about 1 or 2 seconds, but you can see the marshal on the side of the track there, but he's fixed the tyre wall that was damaged. And who's this just in front here? I think it might be Oliver. And is this the tyre that we're getting the pit board? Yes, it is. You can see now the board has been put in, and we had to make sure we got past Oliver here, but he's got a good straight line speed. Is he going to give us a bit of a nudge to the side? But we slightly got on the grass, but on the brakes, we're down the inside, up into the first position and ahead of one of the other lap guys. So we're into the pits, we've got a nice advantage in front of us here. Hopefully Oliver stays behind me here. It gives my dad a bit less time in the pits, and that makes me, gives him a bit more time in the pits. So yeah, so slowing down here, you can see the crowd is building for the championship finale. Just kidding. Yeah, so we're coming to the pit lane here. James is waiting on the sidelines, and I'm getting out number four. I'm trying to help him with the pedals here. Not exactly the cleanest ever stop, but yep, okay, Marshall just putting the pedals back to me here. So yeah, so Will is going to try and obviously fight down here to get back, and my dad obviously will be looking to get into the lead of the race for the first time to see whether he can do it. So my dad can overtake, that'll put him in a leading position. He hasn't won a race in a long time. It was the start of 2015 when he last won a race, so this could be a good opportunity for him to win a race. Once again, he's just got to make sure he keeps it on the track at this point now. So we're over halfway through now this endurance race, and it's been pretty exciting, I'm not gonna lie. For me, it was really interesting to watch. I just enjoyed these sort of longer races where you switch over drives and that sort of stuff. It just makes it a lot more fun. James makes the same mistake that he made in that first part of the race there. I don't think my dad's quite close enough to capitalize on that, but Will is definitely going to be closing down as well at this rate. So Will, you know, I can spoil it for you guys, but Will had the fastest lap in this sort of session by like 0.8 of a second, if I remember correctly. Absolutely insane. He was really fast and really on it today. So Will was definitely the fastest driver here today, but he wanted to be with John obviously to help him out with his first time go-karting. So you know, it's still a good effort from John here today. He really tried his best, and I think he said he's going to come in the future, so hopefully he will for the main championship season starting up soon. But yeah, thank you guys, I suppose, in general, for the support on these videos just ever. I mean, it's been really good to see that you guys don't mind seeing stuff that's a little bit different, obviously, not just F1. It's nice to have that bit of variety, isn't it? To have that bit of variety of something a little bit different. It's still racing at the end of the day. It's real life racing that I've captured myself, and you can hear there's somebody quite close behind here. Is it my dad? Is it Will? We will see at some point, I'm sure, how close the people are behind us here, but we've got a good chance at just keeping this position towards the end of the stint. I'll be pretty happy with that. just realised, like, when you make these videos, you're talking for so long and you're rambling on for so long. Hopefully the videos actually are still exciting for you guys. I mean, I've realised in the future maybe some of the commentaries haven't been incredible for these go-kart races, but I try my best to give a bit of insight about what's actually happening on the track at a certain time. Obviously, it's a bit weird. I mean, you don't normally have a commentator who actually was part of the race itself. You don't see it in Formula 1 and that sort of stuff. Obviously, you have people like Martin Brundle. I'm not saying I'm Martin Brundle. I'm not saying that like I'm a good driver and all that, but, you know, good racing driver, but... You know, just have a bit of insight what's happening on the track at the same time. I think it, you know, it's all right, maybe. Maybe, I don't know, maybe it's not. But we've got probably just over 5 minutes to go in this race. It's going to be switched back to me to the latter part of the race soon. I think Will is quite close, if I remember correctly, at this part of the race. Will was extremely close. My dad was actually quite close as well. So it's very, very close for the first position at the moment between three people. Myself and James obviously currently leading. I think Will and John have moved up into second position, and my dad currently sitting in third position in this race here. So we've probably got one more lap. I think this could be the last lap. Will James be still leading towards the end of this stint? Well, let's hope that he can. Let's see if he can bring it into the pit lane in first position. That would be ideal. Maybe we've got one more lap after this. That would be great. To be perfectly honest, have one more extra lap in the lead of this race and hopefully bring it into the pit lane at the end of this lap. Let's see. So anyway, building up the speed across the start finish line and down to the first corner here. And I think this is where, do we see an overtake coming here up to the top hairpin? I don't think we do. Up to the top hairpin, James still leads here up through the top hairpin, which is great stuff for us. Obviously, we need to be staying. Well, we want to go into the pit lane in the first position. It means that obviously we have a good opportunity to just get out there, get out of the pits, and then move away. Hopefully, so you can see we're lining up here, and we're all standing up in the pit lane here. So we're ready to switch over. This is the last lap James will be doing in this race. Can he keep it? We've only got couple of corners to go here. Oh no, this contact, Tom L. Where did he come from? I didn't realise that Tom L was so close there. He has made contact with James. James is half spun. And Will and John are not close enough. I expected them to be so. Tom L has drove an incredible stint there. I didn't even know how close he was here. All bunched up towards the end there. And now Will looking to go into the pit lane first. This side by side, Will nearly exits. Will nearly has to go around for another lap there. Not sure what's happening there. We switch over here. We're all switching over to our next drivers, obviously, except for my dad, who was just waiting here. But time lost in the pit lane in comparison to Tom L and Oliver. Don't think that much. Probably a tiny bit, actually, to be perfectly honest. But John, he's just come out of the pit lane just behind us here. And, yeah, so actually Tom L wasn't in the battle, was he? I forgot. Tom L wasn't in the battle for the lead, so he's not lead. We're still leading this race here, but we just had a bit of time that lost us, well, quite a bit. So Tom L was like a lap down, I think, at this point here, because Oliver made a mistake in his first stint, which put them like a lap down or something. So that's why this battle is just the two people, obviously, behind John and my dad and myself battling over for the lead here. And Oliver, who's just in front of us here, he actually isn't... In the battle for the championship, in the battle for the race lead, and we just go past him down the straight here, which is good. You know, to risk anything on the brakes, to just turn it in. And yeah, you can see my dad and John battling over second position. At this point, I was like, just get as many seconds over those guys as possible, and it's hopefully done at this point here. So yeah, I just need to make sure that these last few laps of this race here were solid. They were not like over ambitious. They weren't like sliding around all over the place. Obviously, one mistake and I could be off on the grass and I could be spun around and I could lose the race. So just need to be concentrating at this point of the race here. Obviously, with less than 3 minutes, just over 2 minutes to go of this race here, and we've got a nice position to hopefully hang on to here and hopefully seal a nice win in the championship. As I said, this was the last round of the championship, obviously due to the last round being cancelled. So whatever happens here today, whatever the race result is, Tom L will take the most wins trophy away with him at the end of the standings. But what's going to be interesting is obviously because in the first round, myself and James had the same amount of points. Obviously, we're going to get the same amount of points here today. So, will the championship be equal points for the winner? And we'll see at the end here. But the championship standing is going to be very, very close here. I'm not actually sure how it's all going to play out. We'll have to look at the standings. Can't remember how the standings look at the end, actually. So, we'll see how everything looks out here. But yeah, pretty interesting. And is there a yellow flag here? That's why I'm slowing down here. It looks like a yellow flag at the top here, but I think it might have been Oliver who's made a mistake. Oh no, it's John who's made a mistake here. He's spun into the barriers there, thanks to the marshal running away. John, obviously, first time, as I said, as with Oliver, so it was expected. It was definitely expected for them to make mistakes on their first time here go-karting, and it's good that it's good to have them, making mistakes, because then you're learning. Like, for the next time you go through that corner, you know what's happening. So, up to the top hairpin, the yellow flag has been withdrawn. So currently, I'm leading, or myself and James are leading. Oh, very wide there from Oliver. Yeah, we're leading. My dad is in second place. Third place is John and Will. Fourth place is Oliver and Tom Elwitt. Oh, that was incredibly close there. Don't think Oliver was using his peripheral vision there. He didn't see me be on the outside there. I mean, I know it wasn't exactly an overtaking opportunity normally, but you know, when it's someone's first time go-kart and they're not as quick through certain parts of the track here, and Oliver goes through, obviously, for being fast in a straight line. And now hopefully in a straight line, hopefully we'll manage to go down on the brakes. Hopefully, maybe. No, he's faster in a straight line there, Oliver, and he makes a mistake on the brakes. He's just slightly going over the edge with the brakes, slightly braking a bit too late. That's obviously not what you need, but it's all good experience at the end of the day. And I think there's only two laps remaining here after this one. We'll see. But around the final corner, once again, I've had a lap stuck behind Oliver. But I can't quite get the overtake done once again. It's just too fast in a straight line there for me to get past. So, once again, we're going to have to look for the straight line. Is it going to be a risky move? We didn't need to really risk anything at this point. I knew my dad wasn't going to be too far behind, but every minute I was stuck behind Oliver, I was losing time. So, yeah, I needed to make sure that I got past quickly. And that's exactly what we did when he was late on the brake. So, yeah, I'm not sure that this is the last lap that we're watching here, or whether we've got one more lap afterwards. We'll see. Around the final corner, up to the start line. Is this the checker flag? Yes, it is. So there we are. We take home the win in the endurance race there, which I'm happy about. And James was too. So we win the race. We don't get the fastest lap. The fastest lap went to Will and John, like it was last year. That the points go to both drivers, even if it wasn't John that got the fastest lap. We'll assume it was Will. Even though that happened, Will and John still get the points for fastest lap. So, interesting. I got my first win in a very long time. James won, I think, not that long ago in the main championship. John and Oliver had decent starts to their go-karting careers. But yeah, that's how the standings looks. Very good. That's why it was so interesting going to that last round. I really hoped it wasn't called off, because it meant that it was going to be a really interesting championship finale. But that is actually the last, that is the final standing. So, me and James equal on points, then Tom L 1 point behind in third, my dad in fourth with 39, John and Will both on 25, Oliver on 16, James's dad on 15, and Phil on 12. That's how these standings are over for the 2015/2016 Winter Championship. Thanks guys for watching, hopefully you enjoyed it. Spinax, I'm out of here. Goodbye.